Okay, Italy has 26 IPCs to spend. It's turn four. They're going to buy two transports for 14 and an artillery and a destroyer for 12. They have two attacks to make, both in North Africa, both trying to get the bonus. They will be trying to take Tobruk with the infantry from Libya and one fighter from southern Italy. They will be landing in Alexandria with a combined paradrop and amphibious attack. The transport from C-Zone 95 will be moving to C-Zone 99, picking up an infantry and a tank, and landing in Alexandria. And there will be two paratroopers from southern Italy landing in Alexandria with the air transport there. So we only have one thing to roll, and that's the Tobruk attack, so we'll get that set up. Okay, this is the attack on Tobruk. I have committed that this will be a fight to the death. Oh, sorry, that's backwards. So there's an artillery and a fighter coming in against an artillery. So I do want to take the territory because I really want this bonus. So I will be losing the fighter if necessary to do so. So a two and a three. Hit with the fighter. So the battle is won, but we'll see whether or not this guy knocks out the fighter. And he does, you bugger. So the fighter is killed, but the territory is taken, and Italy is going to get a new bonus. Okay, non-combat for Italy. First off, two infantry and two artillery from northern Italy are going to be railed to eastern Poland. That's one, two, three. Two infantry from southern Italy will move north to northern Italy. And then the air transport that participated in the Alexandria attack will land in Greece. So that's it for non-combat. Okay, placement of new units. The new artillery is going into northern Italy. And all of the Navy, the new destroyer, and the two new transports are going into C-Zone 95. In terms of income adjustments, there are none, but Tobruk is now liberated, and Alexandria is now Italian, which does activate some bonuses. So, in terms of the financial situation, the Italians are having a 15 IPC base income, but several bonuses are activated. So they do get 5 IPCs because there are no Allied warships in the Mediterranean. They do get 5 IPCs for controlling Gibraltar, southern France, and Greece, or the Axis controlling Gibraltar, southern France, and Greece. They get 5 for controlling all of North Africa from Morocco to Alexandria, and that is true. And then they're going to get 3 IPC bonus for holding Tobruk, Gibraltar, and Alexandria. So that is a grand total of 15, 25, 33 IPCs that they're going to pick up. So that's $20 right there. Plus, let's not forget, they do have the propaganda technology, or the propaganda, I guess it's a tech, right? In addition to the 33, they are going to get 4 more, so that's going to be 33 plus 4 is 37, so I will take a 5, and I will take a dollar away. So 37 IPCs for Italy on this turn to put in their treasury. That's pretty excellent. Okay, disposition of forces for the Italians. Let's start over here in eastern Poland. There are 2 infantry and 2 artillery. In northern Italy, there are 2 infantry, 1 artillery, and 2 anti-aircraft. In southern Italy, there are 2 infantry, 2 anti-aircraft, 2 fighters, plus, of course, there are 2 German fighters and 4 German tactical bombers. In C-Zone 95, we have 2 transports, 1 cruiser, and 2 destroyers. In Albania, there are 2 infantry. In Greece, there are 2 infantry plus an air transport, currently an air transport. In C-Zone 98, there is a transport. In Alexandria, there are 3 infantry and 1 tank. And in Tobruk, there is an artillery. So that's the Italians. Next up are the minor allies, the Canadians, the Aussies, and the French, who are going next. So my opponent will send me those moves shortly.